Ambi, one of the most predominant design motive in Indian textiles. Ambi literally translates to raw mango, which for the brand's founder means imperfection in beauty. We visit their brand new store in New Delhi and meet Sanjay Garg. I'm very good. I was just admiring your latest. Is this the Bagicha collection?
That's right. That's the Bagicha.
So what was the inspiration behind it?
The whole summer garden. The Bagicha is, the motifs have come from summer garden. You can see the small flowers. This kind of size of a jasmine. You see this beautiful bunch of bouquets of the flower, which is very interesting actually. And it's made from the Russian market. And they wore it as in a big robe.
So this was from an Afghani old robe.
That's right. It's okay. From 18th century, and this has come from papier-mâché in Kashmir.
Yes.
That's how you see the small motif,
the
nakashi on the papier-mâché painted by hand.
Amazing. Well, Sanjay, today I am very well prepared. I have a long
thank
list
you.
Of questions.
Okay,
with me.
Please.
So should we get started?
Yes, please.
Come, let's go that side.
Let's go. Thank you.
Your journey in the world of fashion started in 2008.
Yes.
How?
I started my journey in 2008, but I don't think so I'm part of fashion that way. I started with Dilli Haat and I with Craft Council. I remember still my days, I had a small stall in once in Mumbai at one of the Shivaji Museum. So I worked with Laila Tayyabji, J.R. Jaitley. That's how I started my journey. I don't think so I had any ever shown my work in Fashion Week for Raw Mango. Then we had another brand called Sanjay Garg. That has been shown four to five times in Fashion Weeks.
So what's the difference between the clothes at Raw Mango and at Sanjay Garg?
Well, Raw Mango has been mainly unstitched, more of a pure textile. They're only textile and sarees. And everything related to wear in terms of stitched garments are part of Sanjay Garg.
All right. Now you hail from Rajasthan.
That's right.
How do you borrow things, or what have you borrowed from your Rajasthani sensibility?
I think there are two things. I think first is the color. Very much color is a very essential part of our work. Whether I do sari or a garments, or a lehenga, or wedding. I think you can see the vibrancy of color, the way we combine the color, the boldness of it. There's nothing called wrong or right. I think it's just if you put some colors together, there's nothing called sophistication or not sophistication, or desi, or modern, or elegance. I don't believe in such things. I think that kind of definitely confidence have come from Rajasthan. And secondly, because I grew up in a village, I've seen culture, tradition, very, very closely. I've seen things where you do it not just because someone is going to look at you or there's a ritual. You just do it without thinking anything. So you kind of live in it. Like you just be part of so much that is interwoven. And you can only realize that what you will lose when you are out of it. The minute I came out of my village, then I see, that much I've lost.
You've spoken about a blouse being versatile. So why don't you take us through the versatility of the Indian blouse?
For sure. I always thought that when someone says, oh, this is Indian garment, this is a Western garment, I never understood it. But to me, when you say Indian and Western, there is a divide. I never understood the divide because imagine if India was the world, then how would the sari will evolve? If there's no trouser and shirt, then what is the sari going to be? What is the modern version of it? You only compare because there is a black, so there's a white, because there is a trouser or a shirt, and versus that. I don't think this is either or. So to me, sari is the most beautiful modern garment, and so is the blouse. I'm going to show you.
I can't wait. Let's see.
Please.
It. Sanjay, I have to say, these cupboards are extremely interesting. I love the woodwork. Where are they from?
Thank you. They're from Kerala. They are around 150 year old. And I bought six of the pair for my house, but ended up giving into the store. And if you really see, it's very beautiful. It's like a textile again, carved on the wood. It's like a curtain.
Absolutely, looks like a curtain.
Yeah.
So here we have the blouses. Now take us through the audience and explain to them the versatility of the blouse.
So I must say this, look at this blouse. So we question what the size is. There's no small, medium, large in a way. So it doesn't have any seam. You wear it like that and you tie it like this. So you could wear it on the jean, you could wear it under the overcoat in the winter, so you wear it in summers, you wear it with sari. So there are people who think they need to pin their sari, they can take their pallu like that and they belt it on the top. So it's quite a versatile garment.
Absolutely.
And look at this. If you think that there is a blouse and a jacket, but it's just a blouse, and you wear it this way.
Oh, this is amazing. So it's like a wraparound blouse.
Yeah, it's like a wraparound blouse. You wear it like this, and this comes over it.
This is so cool. So who thought about this?
Well, our team. Let me give this credit to whole design team.
This is amazing. That's blown me away. That is
even
very...
this one also, that you could wear with many different colors.
Yes.
That is A. B, you know, you wear as a blouse, but at the same time, it's like a jacket. So if you are in a cold weather or is in an AC, you wear over the blouse, you wear as a jacket.
Right.
Or you could wear with a white shirt on top of it, or you wear as a blouse. So it's kind of a jacket come blouse.
This is amazing. Well, I'm absolutely blown away by the wraparound blouse. That's super cool. You have so many celebrities who wear your clothes. Who, according to you, carries them off the best?
Well, I think they all do, but my most favorite is Kiran Rao.
All right. For our viewers, can you tell us about some ways how we can take care of delicate fabrics like chanderi?
I think best way is to that you keep changing fold, or you roll of them on a wooden stick. If you roll the sari, any most fragile kind of garments can be also saved. Any kind of textile is much better.
Okay. And take us through some styles for women who want to add a modern touch to the traditional look.
I don't say traditional, modern, two things. Traditional is modern to me.
Okay.
So I don't think there are two different things. As I said, you don't need to try hard what is modern and tradition. One need to wear what is body type suits. And also what your lifestyle is.
What's the advice you give to brides who are picking up the trousseau? How should they curate it or put it together?
So I think it's very, again, very dependent on the bride. She wants to be comfortable. Definitely those 80 kgs of lehenga versus we have 3 kgs of lehenga. They're as ornate and they look very Indian and essential and very old vintage. So it depends on person type. Do you want to become a doll and sit and everyone look at you, or you want to be one of them and be around? It depends what is a bride today. A bride today is that want to be served that day, or she's also wants part of everything. She wants to be comfortable, dance, meet everyone. I think it's again very much the person you are. Everyone has dreamt of some kind of wedding day. I think one need to definitely follow it, but definitely one more thing, that it doesn't have to be very trendy. I really want them to wear that outfit once or few more times in their life, you know. It's not just ending up, it's a wedding garment, I don't think so, I can wear it again. I think that should not happen.
And who's the coolest bride you've ever met, or the coolest client you've ever had?
Well, the coolest clients that way are people who wore cotton saris, like khadi saris, white on white. But having said that, I don't think so. You know, when I say this is coolest and that is not coolest, I should not really generalize, but there are people who are not really bound to by social terms. Cool to me is that you wear it what you have dreamt of.
All right. And for people who are not sari wearers, what do you think should be the first sari they buy?
I think the most basic one. We have saris from 4,000, 5,000. There are more chanderis. They could go for white and gold and silver, more monochromes, and more easy to go with different kind of blouses, maybe black, maybe neutrals, beige.
Now we have a challenge for you. We have a young girl with us. If you could make her try on some of the coolest saris that you have, which you think would be appropriate for her. If you could give her a quick makeover.
Let's do it.
Hi
Tanvi. How are you?
So Tanvi, this is Sanjay. So Sanjay, this is Tanvi. She is an advertising student in Pune who's currently interning at an advertising agency and is wanting to experiment with a sari. What do you want a sari to be like? What kind of a sari are you looking for?
Since I'm not really used to saris, I want something that's just really comfortable to wear and like sort of easy to also drape by myself.
So are you ready for the challenge, Sanjay?
Let's do it, yes.
Great.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So what have you picked and why have you picked these?
Okay, well, I picked these two saris. First of all, this blouse can be worn with both of them. And they're under 10,000. They're made with mul fine khadi cotton.
How lovely.
So it's perfect for the weather kind.
It's amazing.
And you could wear these colors very well at the office.
And they're great for the summer. And I think it's so light. Just touch the fabric. It's beautiful.
I really like this one.
Yeah.
Great. So which one are you going to begin?
I think I'll go with the white.
Okay.
Like, I really like the fabric.
Can't wait to see you, Tanvi.
Yes.
But Sanjay, it's amazing how sari in today's context is not just a garment, but it is 9 yards of canvas where people who wear a sari have given it their own voice, their own individuality. Some wear it with sneakers, some wear it with t-shirts, some wear it with the jacket, some belt it up, some wear it with a waist bag. But I have a question for you, which is how can we get rid of the traditional petticoat? How can you wear a sari without a petticoat?
I'll show you sari, how to wear it without the petticoat.
Amazing.
Yes. So I think it's very simple. You could just knot it up like that.
Okay.
It's tight.
And then you drape it on it.
Then you just drape it on it.
All right. This is such fun. This has been a great learning. Because I have so many saris, and just to find a matching petticoat sometimes is such a problem.
Oh, and more also weather kind. It's perfect for the weather. You don't have to wear many, many.
Okay.
So this is it. You just wear it.
This is amazing.
And you can wear with the t-shirt, with the shoes, with the coat.
This is amazing. And you know, I'm always bothered by finding the matching petticoat, and wearing a sari on a knotted base is so convenient.
That's how it was worn.
Really?
In India, yes.
But then how did they get the pleats right? Or that was just practice?
No, pleat is only a peg, nothing to do with the petticoat. Petticoat just a string. And that's how I did with the knotting. So you know how tight you need to go, and then you just put the pleating over it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, welcome.
This has been a great help. Amazing, Sanjay.
Thank
fantastic.
You. Thank
and,
you.
And there's Tanvi. How are you feeling?
How amazing.
I love it.
It's thank you.
It's really easy to just move around in, and I'm really loving the black graphic lines, and just the minimal, the black and white really suits my personal style as well, because it's pretty minimal. I really like it.
This is amazing.
That's
I think
great.
You look fantastic. Sanjay,
thank
what
you.
Are your views?
Well, it looks fantastic on her. I think she could wear it, if she has to wear it for the wedding, she can wear with the red or orange and pink and exercise it. And she go to work, she can wear with a black t-shirt, jersey, and you wearing with a black blouse. It works for both and fits into your budget.
Amazing. Great choice. Thank you so
thank
much,
you.
Sanjay.
Thank you, Ambika.
And this has been a great learning.
My pleasure.
Tanvi, do remember us when you climb the corporate ladder. And good luck.
Thank you.
Journey of a brand, a quick makeover, and how to wear a sari without a petticoat. That's a lot of information for just one episode. We'll catch you again very soon. Thank you so much for watching.